Very good morning, students. Myself Sanjay Kumar Tiwari, teacher of English language and literature, welcoming you to e-learning platform of St. Michael Higher Secondary Chhamni Bethnia. Students, we have been uploading different videos related to different subjects in very interesting and in very useful manners. As you know that I started teaching you the Shehnai of Bismillah Khan, the second chapter of second unit, taken from the book behind. This present lesson is going to depict you one of the greatest musicians, not only of India but also for world. Here we are going to discuss about the life, style, beginning lives of Bismillah Ali Khan, who brought Shehnai to an international level and international name and fame. We have come to know that it was Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb who banned Pungi, the initial musical instrument, which was later on converted into Shehnai. The Pungi was banned due to the unpleasant sound that was produced by Pungi. It was the verdict of Emperor, and it was followed by each and every citizen of the country, and it became a rule. Later on, a barber, one who was very close to the family of Aurangzeb, came and took the risk to revive the tonal quality of Pungi. Pungi was converted into a pleasant musical instrument producing pleasant sound that was known as Shehnai. Shehnai, as I have stated, that it is a combination of two words, Sah plus Nai. Sah means royal family and Nai means barber. Later on, after the combination of these two words, it was known as Shehnai, and ultimately it became very popular just musical instrument that was permitted to be played by the same Emperor Aurangzeb in his royal palace. But the entire credit for making it a musical instrument of an international level goes to Bismillah Ali Khan Sahab, who brought it to an international level, international quality and international name and fame. As you know that Bismillah Khan was born in Bihar. It was the place Dumra near Sitamadi, and he was awarded with a laddu of more than 1 kg that was given him while he was just singing Chaita, and the present Maharaja of the state, the present Maharaja of the place, awarded him with laddu of more than 1 kg. And it was just a great achievement in the life of Bismillah Ali Khan. He has told it, he has made it clear that being awarded with laddu is better than and is more useful than any other awards in his life. It's a matter of great surprise that he belongs to a family of great musicians. His grandfather, his father, his maternal uncle, as I have stated in previous video, they were very famous for their musical tone, and they were just engaged somewhere else. Later on, he was taken to Benares, which is now known as Banaras, where he used to play his Shehnai with his maternal uncle for more than an hour, and he had a strong session of very bona fide practice that he did and that he made. This changed his tonal quality, and he was a man of great tonal musical instrument that was approved by most of the common musicians of the time. It was 1936 when he was given a big break in his life, and when he was given a big chance in his life, that he was invited by All India Radio, Lucknow, and where he was just heard from time to time. Thereafter, he was invited by the first president, Jawaharlal Nehru, in 1947, when our country got freedom, and he was invited there to play his Shehnai near the Red Fort. That was also a great achievement. After that, he never looked behind, he never turned up his mind, and he always went ahead and ahead. He also performed his musical performance not only in India but outside of the country also. He went to Afghanistan where he was awarded by the Afghani emperor, Afghani king, who was deeply influenced by his musical performance. He was awarded thereof. Most of the awards have been awarded to Bismillah Ali Khan, who was awarded Padma Bhushan, Padma Shri and other awards also. Once he was also told to become a part of filmy world, and two films have been very famous. One of them is Goonj Uthi Shehnai and the second is Kannada film. Exactly the name of the film is Sanada Apna. But after that, Bismillah Khan Sahab took a very strong decision that he would never become a part of unreal filmy world. This was a great decision that was taken by Bismillah Ali Khan Sahab. This was a turning point, and this was a very much bona fide tone of his life that he wanted. He decided to keep himself away from all just unreal words. Students, I would like to make you clear that it was the year 2001 when he was awarded the greatest civilian award known as Bharat Ratna. When he was awarded, his eyes were full of tears. He was very much happy. He was very much delighted to be awarded like that. Students, once he was in America and one of his students, one of his followers put a proposal before him, and the proposal was to stay there in America to spend the remaining part of his life. But he was a great lover of India, he was a great lover of Banaras, and he was a great lover of Dumra Sitamadhi also. So he put two conditions on his own behalf, and the conditions were very much important, and they are sufficient enough to show that how much love he has for India, how much love he has for Indian culture, how much love he had for great Indian classical music presented through Shehnai. It was the love that he had for India. He put that if you can bring the holy river Ganga here, and if you can just have the same structure of Lord Pashupati, Lord Vishwanath, as it is there in Banaras. The student, one who was very much influenced by his quality, by his love for India, he became failure and he couldn't fulfill the first proposal that was bringing the holy river Ganga to that place. So students, you can really imagine, you can really understand his love for Indian culture, Indian society, India, and for Sitamani Dumra also. He has made it clear that whenever he was outside of the country, he always missed Banaras. When he was in Mumbai, when he was in Banaras, he always missed his native place, Dumra. Once he has expressed his desire that he has a strong feeling for Dumra and he wants to go there before the end of his life. But this desire couldn't be fulfilled, and he was not there in Dumra and Sitamadhi because he couldn't get a chance. Students, he has made it clear that once, if you are in India, if you love Indian culture, if you love Indian society, you have to be very sympathetic towards it. Students, thank you. Rest of the progress, rest of the points will be just out to you in next video. Thank you.